You met me deep in my despair to show me you would never leave me there. You claimed me 'cause I was made for so much more. I am your child and I'm worth fighting for. Go heavy with the weight of my mistakes, you carried me and refused to let me sink under the pressure. You meant for me to soar. I am your child and I'm worth fighting for. Eyes haven't seen, ears haven't heard all you have planned for me, and nothing can separate me from your love. There's so much more still worth fighting for. Now I'm moving by faith and not by sight towards victory. By the power of your might, you're straightening out my path and opening every door. I am your child and I'm worth fighting for. Separate me from your love when there's so much more. Yeah.
Still worth fighting for.
Eyes haven't seen, ears haven't heard all your plan for me,
and nothing
can separate me from your love when there's so much more. Still worth fighting for. That's why I'm pressing towards the mark. Cause the calling on my life is worth fighting for. And I'll keep my mind stayed on you, Jesus. Because the peace it brings is worth fighting for. And I'll be faithful to my wife and children. Because my family is worth fighting for. No, this world is not my home, but your kingdom here is worth fighting for. I got a mansion over in glory, and my new home is worth fighting for. Till I see it, I'll shout out hallelujah. 'Cause my bread
you doing this morning? Good, good, good. Good morning to everyone at home. Happy, happy New Year. We made it to 2023. A lot of us, it has been a tough year. It's been a blessed year because we are looking at the very next year. So I'm happy to be here. If you are at home, get your communion ready, what you're going to take communion with. Get ready to worship him this morning. We want to thank him for all he has given us and what he has done. So get to your feet. If you want to stand, stand. If you don't want to stand, do that. So let's get ready to praise him. All right.
Hallelujah. New year and another opportunity to give God some praise. Amen. Hallelujah. Have a little talk with Jesus. Tell him all about your troubles. Cast upon him all your cares. Yeah, yeah. Take it to the Lord in prayer.
Who's still the water?
He steals the water, yeah.
Put your hand in the hand of the man who calmed the sea.
Gonna calm the sea.
Gonna calm the sea.
Gonna calm the sea, yeah.
Put your hand in the hand of the man who steals the water.
He steals the water, yeah.
Put your hand in the hand of the man who calmed the sea.
Tossed and driven, battered by an angry sea.
Come on,
hey, when the storms of life are raging, yeah, 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 and the fury falls on me, I know in him I found a friend who's gonna go through till the end. I have no doubt my God can work it out, y'all, and when I come through, I lift my hands and shout.
Put your hand in the hand of a man who steals the water.
He steals the water.
Put your hand in the hand of a man who calms the sea.
Gonna calm the sea.
Gonna calm the sea.
Gonna calm the sea. Yeah.
Put your hand in the hand of a man who steals the water.
He steals the water. Yeah.
Put your hand in the hand of a man who calms the sea. Put your hands in the hand of the man who steals the water.
He steals the water, yeah.
Put your hands in the hand of the man who calms the sea.
Oh, yeah. Yeah. Good morning.
Yeah.
Good morning. Yeah.
Glory.
Come on and put your hands together. Yeah. Hey.
Let it be known that our God saves and our God reigns. We lift you up, up. Let it be known that love has come and love has won. We lift you up. Oh,
yeah.
for all the world to hear.
Oh, a new day has begun. A new day has begun. Something to shout about. Let it be known.
Let it be known that our God saves. Our God reigns. We lift you up, up. Let it be known that love has come and love has won. We lift you up.
Your name now, louder and louder. We lift your name up, higher and higher. We shout your name now, louder and louder.
We lift your name
higher
up,
and higher,
higher and higher.
We shout your name,
we shout your name
louder, louder and louder,
louder and louder.
We lift your name,
we lift your name
higher and higher,
higher and higher.
We shout your name,
we shout your name out.
Let it be known.
I was once told the story of a far-off king who on his travels told tales of the kingdom he'd bring. A reign so unfathomable it would flip the world around, uplift the humble, bless the poor, the lost finally found. But this news upset the powers that vied to be on top. So they conspired to kill the king and bleed him for every drop. Celebration rang as this so-called king, ripped away from glory, was presented as worse than murderers as they ended his life story. Now, something happened that day. The tales I hear, they differ. Some say that was the end, while others speak of being delivered. Which version to believe is highly contended, but if one chooses neither, then both are offended. But here's what I can make of it, the facts that I can see. This king spoke of a kingdom. Of that, almost all can agree. One where the poor would be looked after, the captive set free, the humble raised up high, a new era of jubilee. And since that fateful day, nothing has been the same. Fishermen stood before kings and emperors, challenging their reign. Prisoners became liberators, giving voice to the oppressed. The reborn repositioned as joint heirs, highly blessed. So from what I can see, the world turned upside down that day when the king rose from the grave and invited us to join the fray. He repositioned us for greatness, not for treasures we take to the grave, but so that the world would hear his story of the king who came to save.
Amen. The king who came to save. Yeah. Am I at the right one?
Should I get over there?
Huh? Over here?
This is where the short people.
A couple announcements we want to make. First of all, we want to thank all of those who supported and worked with us through the series of funerals that we had recently. You guys showed up and showed out as normal and really ministered to families, even some of them who don't normally come to church. As a matter of fact, their first visit to church in a long time has been since the last funeral. And so you matter when you minister that way, and I just want to let you know that. Secondly, those who showed up for the youth. Not only was it a blissful, entertaining time that was a joyful presentation, but it was also a message to them that says that they matter. And so we want to kind of highlight that. Now, this is the last series in our, the last sermon in our Ephesians series. And so we want to take what we've learned and we want to put it to practice. So we will be talking about, again, small groups. This thing keeps coming around. Some small groups, some ministry groups, some fellowships, some other kinds of things that we feel like we need to put in place because the Bible says so. And so we'll talk about what that looks like, you know, post-pandemic, what that looks like in our era where we are more selfish and innerly focused, and that we're, what's important to us is sometimes what's more than what's important to God. So we hope to challenge those areas of your life. The other thing is we're bringing in the new series, and if you picked up on the table, there's a sheet that says The King of Glory. The King of Glory is our new series. It will take place from January 1, which is, this is the transitional. It's taking us from Ephesians to this series. And so the title of today's sermon really focuses on the King's army. And then, well, it focuses on the uniform of the king, of the glory givers. And then January, next week, we will focus on, we'll start in January 1 and go all the way to Easter, Resurrection Sunday. And so we'll be looking at John chapters 12 through 19. Which will lead us all the way up to the resurrection of Christ. And so we hope that while we're doing what Ephesians taught us, we'll be understanding our Lord, not seeing him in heaven, but at what it was like for him to walk on the earth and to demonstrate the ways we ought to live on a regular basis so that we can incubate that in our lives as a church. So that's kind of our goal and our focus of where we're going forward. And yeah, and so we just ask that your prayers be with the leadership, and as we go along the way, be ready to participate when you're recruited. Amen? All right.
Good morning, Christian Fellowship. Happy New Year. Amen. It's a blessing to even enter into this year because so many didn't make it. So we want to just, for those who are going through this time, we just want to ask that you would just continue to bless their hearts and their minds. But first, here's some ways you can give to our church. And there's four different ways. And if you see the ways that we can give, then we just ask that you would just accommodate those ways, whether it's online, whether it's giving through, just coming in every day, or just sharing God's love. And it's not just about money. It's about your time, talent, and your treasure. And the four ways are, we have a CFBC app, we have a mailing box, we have a Cash App, and we also have a, you can text to give. And those are four ways we can give. Amen? Amen. And now, in reverence to God's word, we would ask that you would all stand. If you can stand, would you please stand? We're in Ephesians chapter number 6. And we'll be looking at verses 10 through 23. A few moments to find that passage. Ephesians chapter number 6, 10 through 23. And it reads as follows. It says, finally, be strong in the Lord and in his mighty power. Put on the full armor of God so that you can take your stand against the devil's schemes. For our struggle is not against flesh and blood, but against the rulers, against the authorities, against the powers of this dark world, and against the spiritual forces of evil in the heavenly realms. Therefore, put on the full armor of God, so that when the days of evil comes, you may be able to stand your ground. And after you have done everything, to stand. Stand firm then with the belt of truth buckled around your waist, with the breastplate of righteousness in place, and with your feet fitted with the readiness that comes from the gospel of peace. In addition to all this, take up the shield of faith with which you can extinguish all the flaming arrows of the evil one. Take the helmet of salvation and the sword of the Spirit, which is the word of God, and pray in the Spirit on all occasions with all kinds of prayers and requests. With this in mind, be alert and always keep on praying for all the saints. Pray also for me, that whenever I open my mouth, words may be given me so that I will fearlessly make known the mystery of the gospel, for which I am an ambassador in chains. Pray that I may declare it fearless as I stood. Tychus, the dear brother and faithful servant in the Lord, will tell you everything so that you also may know how I am and what I am doing. I am sending him for this very purpose, that you may know how we are and that he may encourage you. Peace to the brothers and love with faith from God the Father and the Lord Jesus Christ. Grace to all who love our Lord Jesus Christ with an undying love. May the Lord have a blessing to the hearing, reading, and obedience of his word. You may be seated.
All right, I want to sing this song, Jesus is the Best Thing. No, actually, one thing that I forgot is that we were supposed to memorize a verse. Not this last week, because we didn't give. Now, last week will be covered in the study that is coming out from our Ephesians series. However, if anybody memorized the verse from week 12, uh-oh, we got a hand up already. Oh, I got to come here. Don't laugh.
This is trouble.
I'm not going to be trouble. Okay. Okay. It says, you mean the week you're then? Okay. Honor your father and your mother, which is the first commandment. Promise.
Right. There we go. There you go.
Thank you.
That was the first time she was not trouble. All right.
I bring the simple offering of praise to you, I sing.
Yes.
My grateful heart today,
yes,
with joy it gives you thanks, you that lights my way, and with all my gratitude, I lift my hands and worship you. All this love from my heart to your ear, I just wanna say you're the best thing to happen to me.
Right here with you,
yeah,
is where I wanna be.
It's clear to see.
It's clear to see.
Y'all know it, come on.
You're the best thing to happen to me.
Oh,
you gave your life,
yes,
just to rescue me.
It's clear to
it's
see.
It's clear to see.
You're the best
you're
thing.
You're the best thing.
Everybody, come on.
A loving God you are.
God, you are.
You took my broken heart.
Took my broken heart.
And held it in your hand.
Yeah.
Your healing touch was there.
It was there.
to show me that you care,
show me that you
for
care.
Me to live again.
Ooh, yeah.
And with all my gratitude,
my gratitude,
I lift my hands,
yeah,
and worship you.
And worship you, yeah, yeah.
All this love from my heart to your ear, I just wanna say you're the best thing to happen to me. Right here with you is where I wanna be.
It's clear to see.
It's clear to see.
You're the best.
You're the best.
You're the best thing
to happen to me.
Oh.
You gave your life,
yeah,
just to rescue me.
It's clear to see.
It's clear to see.
You're the best.
You're thing. The best.
You're thing. The best thing.
I know it's true, falling in love with you was the best thing I've done, and my life
it will never,
has never been the same.
And with all,
and with all of my heart, I want to say, always be the best thing in my life. You're the best thing.
You are the best thing.
You are the best.
You're the best.
Come on, y'all, sing it, y'all.
You are the best thing.
You are the best.
You're the best thing.
You are the best thing.
As long as there exists,
as long as there exists the day and night. Always be the best thing in my life. You're the best thing.
You are the best thing.
You're the best thing.
You are the best thing.
You're the best thing.
You are the best thing.
As long as there exists,
as long as there exists the day and night.
You're the best thing.
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 Oh, you're the best thing.
You're the best thing.
You're my best thing.
You're my best thing.
You're my best thing.
You're the best thing.
You're the best thing.
You're the best thing.
Whoa, 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 whoa.
You're the best thing.
Yeah, dun, dun.
You're the best thing.
You're the best thing.
You're my best thing.
One more time.
You're the best thing.
You're my best thing.
You're the best thing.
You are my best thing.
You're the best thing.
Whoa, whoa, whoa.
You're the best thing.
Whoa, whoa.
You're the best thing.
Praise the Lord, everybody.
Praise the Lord.
As we gather here today on this New Year's Day, I want you to think as we start about how blessed you really are. Some of us might not have felt like we had the greatest year, but think of how blessed you are.
Yeah, yeah. Come on.
Think of all of the people that celebrated New Year's Eve in your neighborhood with celebratory gunshots and all of that. And now try to take and compare a New Year's celebration versus eternity. Each and every one of us have got eternal life. Now, which one longs the best?
Come
I mean, lasts the longest. As we get into our deal today, Paul makes an interesting statement. He says, finally, my brethren, he's talking to church people in a neuter sense.
Come on now.
He says, be strong in the Lord and the power of his might. And then he goes on to say, put on the whole armor of God that ye may be able to stand against the wiles of the devil, or the deception of the devil.
Yes.
Now, do you notice it never tells us to fight the devil?
Come on, sir.
It never tells us to rebuke the devil. Right. It never tells us to step on the devil's neck.
Come on now.
In fact, scripture says even Gabriel, the archangel, wouldn't bring a railing accusation against Satan concerning Moses' body. How many know that's something that you can't play with?
That's right. Say that.
But I'm here to tell you this morning that some of us are old school. And I can remember growing up in the church when anybody could whoop you if you did something wrong.
Right.
Come on now.
Somebody know what I'm talking about.
Yeah.
But most of the time when church was going on and you start acting up, all someone had to do was give you a look.
Watch out now, that look.
And you knew what that meant.
Oh my
God. I want you to think about Jesus Christ this morning. Because scripture says when he was resurrected and he ascended on high, he said, all power has been given unto me in heaven and earth. Go ye therefore, preach the gospel, teaching all nations to observe whatsoever I commanded you. And lo, I am with you all the way, always. Now, I want you to think about yourself being a child of God. And I want you to think about that Ephesians 6 and 10, because that's only when you're being obedient. Because how many know that God can use evil to bring good out of it?
That's right. Yes, he will.
But when you are obedient to God, when Satan starts messing with you as a child of God, all Christ got to do is give him that look.
Come on, man.
So as we get into 2023, I want you to think about where you are, where you need to be. And I also want to think about, as you look back over your life, a lot of us can reflect on the hard times we had and the times we did this or that. Ask yourself, how many occasional spiritual victories have you had in 2023? How many times can you say, you know what, he got me last year, but boy, he didn't get me on that, because I stood strong in Jesus.
Amen.
So we have to learn to let Jesus be our everything.
That's right.
Scripture tells us some very important things. And we want to definitely start it off like this.
Yes.
It tells us as believers in Christ, before we even do this, let us examine ourselves. And we're not trying to say that one person is worse than the other one or nothing like that. We just saying that we are before a holy and a righteous God this morning. So wherever our hearts and our minds are, let's go to him. And whatever it is we need to ask for forgiveness for, he stands there ready to do it. Thank you, Lord. Scripture tells us that on the night that Jesus Christ himself was to be betrayed, he gathered all his disciples into an upper room. He took the bread, he blessed it, and he broke it, and he said, take and eat, for this is my body, which is broken for you. Likewise, he took the cup, and he said, drink ye, for this is the cup of the New Testament. He tells us to do these things in remembrance of him until he comes again. You know, sometimes truth is a hard word to hear. Sometimes we all need it. Let's just go to God in prayer for a moment. Heavenly Father, we come before you as individuals and we come before you as a congregation. You are a God that sits on high, whose eyes searches to and fro, and you know the ways of man. You know our hearts, you know our minds, you know everything about us. Even when we think there's something that we can hide from you, God, you know what's happening. The first thing we ask for you to do for us on this day and all of that everlasting mercy that you have is forgive us as a church. And when I say forgive us of a church, forgive us for not fulfilling the Great Commission. Forgive us for having the truth and not sharing it with no one else. Forgive us for acting like we have a patent on Jesus Christ. And long as we get ours, it don't make no difference if no one else get theirs. Forgive us for not teaching people how to live in Jesus Christ. Forgive us for not allowing people to know that the only hope they have in this life is in Jesus Christ. And then God, forgive us as individuals. Forgive us if we forgot any unforgiveness, we've got any bitterness, any envy, any animosity, anything against each other. Because we've all been through some things, and hey, it should be drawing us closer as a church right now. So as we get out into the world next week, or we go back to our jobs, help us to remember those things. And help us to bring glory to you and to your son every day at our own personal expense. No matter what it costs us, as long as you get the glory. Father, we just pray that you would speak through Pastor Archie today. Let us hear the truth. Let us apply the truth. And let what we're learning not just be a collection of something that we can put in a room in a box. But it can be something to where we really draw closer to Christ and start walking in it. And Father, we give you the praise, the honor, and the glory. In Jesus' name, amen.
Shine out of the ashes we rise. There's no one like you.
None like you.
Oh,
our God is greater. Our God is stronger.
Hey.
God, you are higher than any other.
Than any other.
Our God is healer.
Awesome and high.
Our God is greater, our God is stronger. God, you are higher than any other.
Than any other.
Our God is
a healer, awesome in power. Our God,
our God. Ooh, hey, hey. Ooh, hey, hey.
Water you turned into wine. Eyes of the blind, there's no one like you.
No one like you. No one like
none
you.
Like you. Yeah. Into the darkness to shine. Out of the ashes we rise. There's no one
no
like
one
you.
Like you. No. No one like
none
you.
None like you. None like you. Oh, oh.
Our God is greater. Our God is stronger. God, you are higher than
hey,
any other.
Than any other.
Our God is
my God's a healer.
Awesome in power.
Our God,
our God.
Hey.
Our God is greater. Our God is stronger. God, you are higher than any other.
Than any other.
Our God is healer.
Awesome in power.
Awesome in
us. And if our God is with us, then what can stand against? And if our God is for us, then what could ever stop us? And if our God is with us, then what could stand against?
And if our God is for us, then what could ever stop us?
What could
stop us? And if our God is with us, then what could stand against?
And if our God is for us, our God is stronger. God, you are higher than any other. Our God is healer.
Awesome and powerful.
Our God,
our God.
Hey,
our God is greater. Our God is stronger. God, you are higher than any other.
Our God is healer.
Awesome and powerful.
Awesome and powerful.
See, when I wake up in the morning, the devil says, uh-oh. See, there's an enemy out there that I can't see. I know that he came to steal, kill, and destroy, but I'm here to help set the captives free. Be strong in the Lord and in the strength of his might. I put on the whole armor of God in anticipation of the fight. The church is rising, despising the sin. No longer will we back into the corner we have chosen to win. Flames extinguished, fear diminished. I truly believe in the words when he said, "It is finished." Fastened on the belt of truth, I was made in his likeness. He's the way, the truth, and the life, so now I'm strapped with the breastplate of righteousness. No longer scared, I'm prepared with the shoes of the gospel of peace, rooted in grace. No time to waste. Left hand grasping the shield of faith. I got the helmet of salvation and the sword of the Spirit. The word of God in my life is present. So I look forward to heaven, cause that's where I'm headed. So heaven is embedded in my soul. So church, let them know that Christ is who we know. So church, rise up. See, there's an enemy out there that I can't see. I know that he came to steal, kill, and destroy, but I'm here to help set the captives free. Be strong in the Lord and in the strength of his might. I put on the whole armor of God in anticipation of the fight. So I'll renew my mind. This life is no longer mine. The tomb was empty, redemptive plan, like free gold from a mine. Let me remind that you can't rewind. So when we move forward in time, I'm gonna go ahead and let this little light shine. No longer will I wait for the move of God. I decided to be the move of God. I'm walking from the cross, which means I'm walking from victory, and no longer for it. Confidence that God's got my back, then you can't ignore it. So church, rise up. See, when I wake up in the morning, the devil says, uh-oh.
Play hard, but getting beat by 30 points. Amen. I just hope the Chiefs don't do that. All right, so the Cowboys are still trying to get in the Super Bowl, still trying to get in the playoffs. So, you know, for those folks, the Raiders benched their quarterback. Just give me your updates. And Patrick Mahomes is looking to be the MVP of the year. Amen. All right. So, all we want is the Bills to lose and us to keep winning. Amen. Amen. All that's in the Bible. No, just kidding. Let's go to God in prayer and ask for his blessings on the morning as we enter into this last passage from the book of Ephesians. God, we just are grateful for so many things. The year is changing. And since 2020, we've seen drastic shifts happen in our society. What has happened is the darkness has been uncovered a bit. So we can see how dysfunctional we are. We have separated to the degree where accountability has become invisible. We have become more selfish, more inwardly focused. More, it's all about me. And in fact, we have substituted you for things like ancestry and all those different kinds of other things, for energy and for power and good vibes and all those different kinds of things. As if it's easier to believe in the nothingness than it is the reality. We have shifted the definitions of things that you have created. We have changed covenants that you said are paramount to humanity. And then you told us to be light in the middle of that. And Father, with this series, you have helped us understand how to be light. You have helped us understand a little bit about how we have taken on the culture of the world and we're trying to do church world style. You have helped us to understand that our selfishness has divided us when unity is your focus. You have helped us to understand how much we are worldly and should be biblical. So, Father, we ask that you would take this series and put it into our lives and drive us to be more of what you have called us to be than what the world has shaped us to be. Right now, Father, we will close out this series recognizing the uniform that you've given us to wear in this game. We ask that you would help us to embrace it and to take it into our lives more seriously than anything else, recognizing it is the conduit through which you infuse yourself into everything that we do. We always say this, but always mean it. Let not the speaker stand in the word, but give me give me perfect health, logical progression of thought, and insight into the word as I attempt to reflect your truth in a way that ties it clearly back to you. I want to be your vessel, so use me in that way. In Christ's name we pray. Amen. In Super Bowl 56, Cincinnati was playing the Rams. And a momentum change happened in the middle of the game when a celebration took place and one of the players who was out of uniform came on the field. He entered the play of field without being in uniform. And the problem with that is that it drew a penalty. It drew a penalty, and that penalty changed the momentum of the game. Because here's the bottom line. Might need some water. Here's the bottom line. You cannot be on the field without being properly uniformed. In fact, there's been some players that have taken their helmet off in the field of play and drew a penalty that almost cost them the game. We learn this not only in football, but we learn this in almost everything. You don't get on the field out of uniform if you're in the Army. You don't get on the field out of uniform if you're a police officer. You don't get on the field out of uniform if you play basketball. The bottom line is, the uniform is there for a purpose. And when you find yourself out of uniform, you cannot fulfill the purpose. Christians are the only ones that feel like we can get out of uniform and have no consequence. Our focus today is this: being an effective glory giver, which is what we are. We are glory givers. Being an effective glory giver for Christ requires the integration of the glory giver's uniform into your life as a continuously growing lifestyle change. In other words, it's a continuously growing lifestyle change. This uniform is not an exterior uniform. It's not how cute you are on Easter or Christmas. It's not about your suit. It's not about the car you drive, even the hair you buy, wear. It's not about any of those things. It is really about whether or not the internal you is being transformed so that you fit the uniform standards that have been put out.